Number four, remember the definition of independent events are things that are not affecting one another. So you're not affecting the total of something, or you're not affecting the likelihood of something else to happen. Next, if you pick two marbles in one, like in one handful, you pick out two marbles, the first marble that you actually pick out could affect the second marble. You're not doing it in two separate picks, but because you're not replacing that first one, it's actually changing the total number. So if you had whatever, I think there are 5 and 7, so there are 12 marbles total. If you pull that first one out, now you only have 11 marbles. When you're pulling the second one out, even though you're doing them in the same pick, it's affecting the other one. So same for letter B. These two are basically the same kinds of probabilities. They just have different numbers because of the number of red and blue. So then we look at C and D. One of them is with replacement and one of them is without. If you pick a marble and you don't put it back in, that is changing the likelihood that you can get another blue one or a blue one in the second pick. If, however, you pick a red one out, you look at it, oh, cool, it's red, and then you put it back in, you're not changing the total amount that you have in there. So you're resetting it, so that's creating independent events. So it is letter C that is independent.